Someone on the phone has told you they just need to connect to your computer, saying they will connect you to a secure server in order to give you a refund or remove hackers from your account. Why? Greetings and welcome to Scam Takedown Task Force, a community dedicated to finding scams online and spreading scam awareness. You got an email that told you that you had a big purchase being delivered to your house that you never made, or some expensive software subscription was being renewed on your computer and would be automatically charged to your account. When you call the number in the email, the person on the other side says not to worry, they can reverse the charge for you and make sure the hackers are removed from your computer. All they need to do is download some software that they may call a secure server so that they can proceed with the refund. In reality, you were never charged and there are no hackers on your computer. So what does the person on the other side really want to connect to your computer for? Scammers will use a lot of different ways to try to convince you that you need to let them connect to your computer. Some may say that they need to connect in order to secure your computer. Others may say that they need to connect you to their secure servers in order to protect your information. Of course, all the scammer wants to do is connect to your computer, and is willing to say anything that may get you to let them do that. Refusing to let the scammer connect to your computer will often result in them hanging up, as they don't like wasting time with people they don't believe they can get money from. But they may become angry and threaten you with calling the police or saying that your family will be arrested. It's important to know that their threats are hollow and meaningless, just attempts to scare you into giving them access to your computer. There are many different things that a scammer can do once they have access to your computer. They can download all of your personal information that you have saved on your computer. They can get all of your saved passwords on your browser if they are not securely stored. They can install Trojans and keyloggers that would allow them to know every key you type on the keyboard so that they can steal more passwords and login information. Another thing the scammer may do is have you log into your bank account to write down how much is in your bank accounts. They do this for two reasons: to see if you have any money in the first place, and to make sure that you are able to log into the account. They will then show you a CMD screen and have you type your personal information to a secure server in order to process your refund. After that, they will have you enter the refund amount and add an extra zero or two to make it look like they are giving you too much money on your refund. They may play it out like it's a big mistake and edit the HTML of your bank to make it look like they gave you too much money. There are several different ways they might ask for you to return this extra money they pretended to send you, such as wiring the funds, mailing the funds wrapped in tinfoil, or purchasing gift cards. If you refuse, they may make it look like you have no money in your account to scare you into giving into their scam. And if you continue to refuse, they may use the remote access to lock your computer, holding your computer ransom until you give them money. Once the scammer has access to your computer, they have a lot of control, and the longer they have that control, the more control they can add. If a scammer has gained access to your computer, disconnect the internet from your computer. If you don't know how to do that on your computer, unplugging your modem or router that you got from your internet provider will stop them from being able to access your computer. Next, remove the program that they had you install on your computer in order to give them access. If you're not sure how to do this, I've included links down in the description below describing the steps. But you can also contact a local computer repair place and explain the situation and ask if they can help resolve the problem. The scammer may continue to harass you if they notice that they have lost connection to your computer by calling more or sending messages. Block them and don't answer their calls. If you do, they may threaten and try to intimidate you to give them money or access your computer again. Make it clear that you know that they are a scam and that they will not get any of your money and hang up. The best way to prevent scammers from accessing your computer in the future is to not allow anyone remote access to your computer. There are very few instances where this is useful, and besides for a local and trusted tech support company, no one else should really need access in this way. Scammers rely on people's trust or scare tactics. If you did not need tech support and were not actively looking for someone to help you with your computer, then it is very likely a scam and you should stop communicating with them. Being cautious and never giving anyone access to your computer will help prevent this from happening again. Scammers are very deceptive and will try many different tactics to get your money, but understanding how their scam works makes them far less likely to be able to scam you or your loved ones. Be sure to like the video if you found it helpful, and subscribe if you would like to see more of this content. The best way you can help fight against the scammers is to share this video and help spread scam awareness. Until next time, be vigilant, spread awareness, and have a great rest of your day.